my zeal to protect it. My words hurt your feelings. I apologize.
Hang on, please. Please, great, Charlene. Great, Charlene.
Closer to the mic. So sorry. Shall I say anything over?
No.
I know Papaikou is full of clever, hardworking people, and I have been hoping that that talent and that energy would work for the good of this place for years. And I just didn't seem to be able to get anybody on board. And frankly, I took that as a lack of interest. Now, when I see and hear the passion that you have for this place, I say, how did I misjudge that? We watched the video of your community meeting. We couldn't get back here that quick, so we had to overnight in Seattle, and we watched that. And we thought a lot of people had a lot of things to say, and we were impressed by the passion. This new proposed access route will only succeed with community involvement. I mean, the community has got to be managing it and protecting it. But that's the only way that it will work. So I say to you, mull it over, talk among yourselves, ask us questions, mostly to Jim, because he surveyed it and he built the first trail, so he can sure build this one. And just kind of see what you think about it. If we all want it, caring for this place, I think, could bring out the best in all of us. Aloha goes both ways.
Thank you very much for your presentation. I really appreciate it. And audience, thank you very much for your patience. We do have a total of 44 people that have signed up to speak here. If you do want to speak, you do have to sign in at the table here. And just a reminder, I know I mentioned it earlier, I want to mention it again. Each testifier will have 3 minutes to testify. You don't have to use all 3 minutes if you don't want to. Okay? Once again. However, what will happen is, again, the orange line come out, but that means you have 30 seconds left. Ms. Smart is going to lift up that thing that you're reminded. And once that thing buzzes, then I'm going to cut you off at that point.
I was parked at
30 minutes. Sorry, we're going to go with the public decimal. If you want to come at 60 feet, you can do that.
I was parked over there for 30
minutes. I'm sorry? I'm sorry, Willa. You part of his presentation?
Yeah.
How long is your?
5 minutes.
I'll give you 3, go ahead.
Okay. He's going to be waiting in line.
I'll give you 3, go ahead.
Hello, my name is Craig Neff. I know some of you guys don't know me, but it's alright because I don't know you. I live up in Papaikou on this road, maybe like 17 years. I'm part of the community development program. Also, I'm on the Lone South Kilo. Never been meeting a long time, but I'm still on there. But my concern here is the community. I think we all for access, yeah, but my concern is to take care of that place, yeah? Not only to access, yeah? To access some things is good, but too much access, you gotta take care of what's down there, yeah? That's the main concern for me, for the community to come together, yeah? I really need to step forward. It's good to see the Kupuna here. Others here in the community. I wish you had this much people at the CDP meeting, yeah? Where access is a part of the plan, but I'm trying to say I talked to some people in the community already, some from the church, the Hormonji, the Rulo Sapilo. We are willing to come down the beach, maybe 15 for a couple hours, pick up rubbish, and take care. Just, I know the kids got this here, and they did that, but I think the community, Papaikou community itself, need to take ownership of not this land, but of the process, so that when things happen, I mean, my fight in the council, right on, but this home rule, whoever's in these communities, the people that need to take care. Yeah, so I did one, how many of you guys got access to that place? Right? Right? So how many of you guys like come down in Malama and take care of that place? Okay, so you get one pair for area. You can sign up. You're not going to come down every day. You can come down, you can come in one day a year. Yeah, so come down. And that will show people in the community that the communities participate, show the confidence. You know, we're participating and willing to work together. I know sometimes humbug and harm, you have to deal sometimes with landowners. But I'm saying if it's only gonna be bang bang, in the end it'll be hard, yeah, the result. But if us as a community can come and step forward just a little bit and just talk story, I think the benefit will be there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mahalo. I just want to record your CV.
Craig Neff.
Mahalo. Thank you.
Hawaii Force. Come down by my shirt.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to call you three at a time. And again, we just have the first person come here. We have Theo Pisa Tulane to come forward. And if I could ask Pam Linus to come forward as well. And Gerald Tulane to come forward as well. Thank you very much. And you know what, I want to clap for Angie too, I really do. However, again, I just want to remind everybody, we want to make sure that everyone feels comfortable here. So we want to keep, we want no applause from the audience. I really appreciate everybody's cooperation with that. With that said, Ms. Tulane, please proceed.
Hello.
Bring the microphone closer to you.
Mr. Yadam and Kamsu. I'm Mrs. Tulane. I'm born and raised in Papaikou since the early 20s and still around. I'm still around and I think that, you know, the spot where the community is so concerned about, the pathway has been there since I was born. And I used to use the pathway to go down to the river. And when these got the wet and was ready, the plantation was very nice to the occupants, the workers' children. They let us back to the mill, even taught us how to run the elevator to go up and down. The plantation was very nice to the workers. It was so sad one day, I went down and then I questioned my sister who was sick. And she asked, and I said, oh, how's the beach down there? And she said, oh, big. Going down is all right. Coming up will be hot and puff. So I've never been there since the beach been down. That area has been sold. I hope you can consider the wishes of the people that's around that area. I would like them to keep all about the people that actually on the beach and use the beach. Not lock up the doors and shut it out a year and have somebody watching that small little opening. I mean, it's not that bright. It was an open area and I remember my mother and Mr. Felix used to raise pins along the side of the along the side of the hill, and there were many more that were spades, and there was a garden. He had a garden, and then the mill supervisor was very nice to the people that work and the workers. They allow us to go through the mill as long as we don't make hambag. We never made hambag with the workers, and so is the mill. So I hope, in conclusion, that you councilmen and the owners of the property would come to a conclusion that the public will be provided with the constitution. I mean, with the plan they are going to. But we cannot lock the gate and don't allow. I was so happy when I see, you know, young people going down.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mrs. Tula. I really appreciate you.
Thank you.
First of all, thank you for this opportunity to provide for our community and our people. My name is Pam Wyden. Although I'm a resident of Kaumana, my parents and my grandparents, in six generations, know the area very well. My grandparents, shortly after their arrival from the Philippines, resided in a home at the end of the mill road. It's still there, and my cousin and my uncle take care of the home. When my parents were first married, that was the only place that my mom wanted to raise her family. But we were a bit luckier. My brothers and I, our home was between the trash, we call it the big ass house, and the mill pit. So we could see the ocean. I remember seeing the humpback whales, and my dad and my uncles, my grandfather, my brothers loved the ocean. There were three ways to get down to the beach. First of all, as I watched the presentation by Mr. Wong, I quickly could connect. I saw that plume on the Hamakua side. We lived just above that. You could get to the beach going on the plume, but that was pretty treacherous. And that area, remember, erosion takes place. Then, as my mom said, we were allowed to go to the mill. And again, the plantation people were very nice to plantation workers. They knew that this was our recreation. They knew this was where we spent family time, quality spent family time, weekends. And we also enjoyed fishing and just being there up near the beach edge. We even gathered, besides fish and shellfish, mushrooms that grew in the trash. So instead of going through the flume, which was not really the best way for a family, and if my parents felt that was a nice way to go through the trail that is in question today. I know that trail existed there. My mom told you that she took that trail as a young girl. I too took that trail with my family. It's the best trail. It's safe. It's sensible. There's a lot of historic meaning to it for all the people who live in Papaikou. And because my grandparents and my parents always told us, don't fight along the trail, take care of the trail, you know, start arguing. We knew that they respected the area. And I think we need to keep that trail. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Before I come on to the general, I'd like to thank you, Captain Roxanne Watson.